What if humans didn't need to sleep? Sleep. Who needs it? Well, all of us, actually. Typically, sleep takes up 1/3 of our entire lives, which is a sobering and pretty frightening thought. So clearly the obvious answer, and logical starting point, is that if humans didn't need to sleep, we'd have much more time for other things. It'd mean fundamental changes in the way we live, what we do, and how and when we do it. Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more fascinating content. Whether our shift to a sleep-free existence happens immediately or over time, we'd have to restructure everything to benefit from the extra waking hours we'd all enjoy. Which doesn't sound too bad, does it? Or too difficult? But the idea of having more time may have its drawbacks and downsides as well. First off, would we really get more done? Because let's be honest, more free time means more time to waste, right? Binging TV shows becomes easier, beating a new game without having to take a day off work becomes the norm, and general procrastination takes over. But what if you aren't a time waster? What if, even without sleep, you strive to make every second count? There's only so long you could keep it up without your body and mind being affected. After all, we'd still need time out to cope with the everyday stresses of life, and sleep is that time for a lot of people. The economic impact would naturally center on the sleep industry. While we'd probably still keep beds around for comfort and recreation, everything else linked to sleep would become obsolete or extreme luxury items. Dedicated bedrooms would disappear from most households, remaining only in the wealthiest homes as an opulent extra. Manufacturers of cushions, blankets, duvets, and anything designed to make resting comfortable would find themselves without a customer, especially if, in a world without sleep, we never even felt tired at all. It'd be more than just amenities, though, as there'd be a knock-on effect for medical professionals. Sleep specialists would no longer be needed, pharmaceutical companies would no longer produce sleeping aids, and no sleep means no dreaming, so even the role of some therapists would change. Elsewhere, the hospitality sector would be totally different, too. While hotels would still exist as temporary bases for tourists and visitors, they'd need to be much more than just somewhere to sleep.
Do you know if the hotel's pager-friendly?
What do you mean?
That said, any hotel that did persuade its guests to indulge in a period of now unnecessary sleeping could bill itself as though on another level of comfort and extravagance. Without sleep, there'd be more time to work longer hours, and employer expectations could change.
Handling it okay?
Sorta.
If even half of an average night's sleep was spent working, that's 4 extra hours in every 24. Even without physical exhaustion, the mental strain could quickly mount within a worldwide workplace that's impossible to switch off from. On the plus side, for shift work, there'd be more shifts available, which could increase work opportunities. But strict and specific laws would need to be in place to prevent burnout. Assuming that our sleepless bodies would still need to retain energy of some kind, then food industries would surely benefit because we'd all be eating more.
All you can eat! All you can eat!
Without standard sleeping patterns, we'd need more mealtimes too. And with everyone awake all of the time, agreed-upon meals would probably happen at agreed-upon hours. So breakfast is at 8 o'clock everywhere, dinner is at 5, and some kind of other meal always happens around 1 a.m.
64 slices of American cheese.
In general, a regulation of the clocks would set in all over. Yes, we'd still experience day and night at different times, which would still be crucial to farming industries especially, but the Earth's rotation would no longer dictate when most of the world sleeps or wakes. With everything on and everyone conscious all of the time, the excesses would clearly start to show. With food, obesity levels could rise, but also the amount of garbage we make would increase, as would the amount of energy we consume and the pollution we produce. Theoretically, the human impact on global resources would rise by 20 to 30%, given the extra time we'd all be awake. Yes, our homes and bodies still demand something from our planet when we're sleeping, but not nearly as much as they would if we never took a nap. On the plus side, the move would surely force hundreds of recycling initiatives. With the unsustainability of our lives suddenly fast-tracked, there'd be an even greater emphasis on eco-friendly living. There'd be all new jobs created in a quest to save the environment, but also plenty of opportunities in standard emergency services too. The majority of accidents happen when we're awake, so our hospitals would need more doctors, nurses, surgeons, and paramedics. Not to mention the maintenance staff, receptionists, managers, and everyone else that works to keep those places open. The police might also see their duties change, although a little less predictably. While general crime rates are usually highest during the day, a lot of what's illegal happens when no one is watching, at nighttime when they're sleeping. So while there'd still be a cover of darkness at certain hours, the window for violent crimes and theft could close. Then again, potential criminals would be constantly awake, so the burden on the police increases because of that. Meanwhile, without the need for sleep to interrupt their schemes, the likes of fraudsters, hackers, and scam artists could operate around the clock. It's not as though the police would be less busy, just that there could be a change in focus. In happier news, and if our jobs didn't take over everything we did, then the extra time would also mean more leisure time. The entertainment industry would boom, creating more shows, films, games, and music, just to keep people from being bored. And with our enlarged diets threatening to become a major problem, health trends and fitness goals would be even more popular than they are today. With more time on our hands, there'd also be more time to spend with family, friends, and peers.
I got a lot of problems with you people! Now, you're gonna hear about it!
There could be some downsides here, with time to trigger more arguments, but the positives of socializing with more people would likely outweigh the negatives. In terms of couples, there'd again be some extra strain. But on the other side, the extra time together could also start a baby boom. Regardless of how anyone chose to spend their extra time, however, there'd be many mental challenges. At its simplest, sleep is time for our mind and body to heal, for us to forget our problems and process information subconsciously. We usually wake up feeling better for a reason, and the idea of sleeping on it taps into the way in which sleep divides our lives up. As well as the extra worries and stresses that a 24-hour waking society could create, it'd be even more difficult to escape those negative thoughts. Without sleep to provide at least a little structure and downtime, our minds would be working overtime, wrestling with whatever's bothering us, which could lead us to react and behave in ways that we wouldn't normally.
Crying?
Ever pulled an all-nighter? In the real world, we tend to become irritable because of the tiredness. But here, we could be dealing with hours and hours of panic, fear, or sadness without any break. Even if you're in a positive mood, then the fundamental feeling of never-endingness could be confusing. The days would all just kind of blur into one, and we wouldn't know the actual date or even day of the week without looking. With sleep, you could easily recall the things that happened the day before and say, "This happened yesterday." But when you never wake up from anything, it's hard to determine when exactly past events took place. If you didn't keep a diary before, you'd absolutely have to now.
The days move along with regularity, over and over, one day indistinguishable from the next.
It's clearly a tricky balance, but for all the negatives, it's still hard to imagine that a sleep-free world wouldn't in some way equal faster progress in terms of technology, creativity, and general human output. Given average sleeping hours and average life expectancies, we sleep for around 25 years throughout our lives. Consider the global changes that have happened in the past 25 years on current slumber patterns, and the whole of human history would look totally different if we didn't need our Z's. But it's definitely a case of perspective, and there's no getting away from our biological need for sleep. In fact, because of the structure it gives our lives and the opportunity it gives our brains to process and develop, sleeping should really be embraced. If we suddenly didn't need it, then we'd no doubt quickly miss it.
Patio furniture's on sale.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.